Hello everyone. The topic of my paper is role of DWI and DC-MRI in predicting histopathology grade of carcinoma cervix, a preliminary report. Under the guidance of Dr. Yatish Agarwal, Dr. Kritika Sindhwani, Dr. Vijay Zutshi, Dr. Gitika Khanna of Vardhman Mahavir Medical College Surgeon Hospital, New Delhi. Now, cervical cancer ranks as the second leading cause of female cancer in India. The revised LIGO staging has allowed the use of any imaging modality like CT and MRI and or pathological findings for evaluation of local and extrauterine cervical cancer spread for its accurate staging. It has been seen in early stages of cervical cancer, pathological parameters like tumor size, depth of invasion, lymphovascular space invasion are of prognostic value. Tumor grading will determine the course of disease and therapeutic outcome and survival. New MRI techniques like diffusion-weighted imaging and dynamic contrast MRI can assist the changes in tissue cellularity, perfusion, and tissue physiology and can act as parameters and biomarkers of tumor biological behavior. ADC values are seen to be decreasing cervical malignancy, which correlates with increased cellularity. Thus, poorly differentiated tumors have lower ADC and help predict poor prognosis. Studies have also shown that increased permeability areas with increased K-trans and showing enhancement were composed of cancer cell vesicles and were more responsive to radiation therapy. Now, aim and objectives were to determine the relationship of tumor ADC and K-trans values with histopathological grading and staging of cervical cancer. Methodology. CTIPE was a prospective cross-sectional observational institute review board approved in a tertiary care center, BMMC Surgeon Hospital. Sample size was 13 consenting adult female patients with clinical suspicion of carcinoma cervix. It's an ongoing study. Inclusion criteria was adult females with clinical suspicion of cervical cancer. Exclusion criteria were patients with any MR contraindications as cardiac pacemaker, allergy or contraindication to gadolinium contrast material. Patient have received any kind of treatment for the same illness. Gold standard was histopathology from core biopsy. Now, patients with clinical suspicion of CA cervix were clinically evaluated and informed consents were taken. It was followed up by MRI conducted on 3 test units with standard sequences and with DWI and DCE. Tumor ADC and DCE pharmacokinetic parameters, that is K-trans, were calculated, followed up by biopsy to assess the histopathological type and grading, which was gold standard, followed up by statistical analysis. Now, my observations, patient 1 was 57-year-old female with bleeding PV. Axial T2 and SASH T2 shows a heterogeneous lesion involving the cervical lesion, followed up by DWI. DWI shows a hypertense signal, followed up by hypertense signal on ADC showing restriction. Now, ADC mean and ADC minimum were calculated. ADC mean was calculated by drawing a manually drawn arrow encompassing the whole lesion, whereas ADC minimum was calculated by drawing an arrow of at least 10 mm square area and then putting up manually over the lesion to find the minimum ADC value. ADC mean came out to be 92.2 in this patient and ADC minimum came out to be 899.2. Followed by DCE, the ROI was kept in a lesion and the reference ROI was kept in myometrium as in some cases, even the cervical stroma was involved. Now the curve showed that the cervical lesion, the mass lesion showed an early enhancement as compared to the myometry. K-trans lesion came out to be 0.577. Histopathology showed that it was a well-differentiated squamous cell CA cervix. Patient 2 was 60-year-old female with again history of bleeding PV and passage of clots. Axial T2 showed and SASH 2 showed a lesion involving the cervical area. DWI showed that this lesion was restricting. ADC minimum came out to be 773.2. ADC mean came out to be 887.6. On DCE, the lesion again showed an early enhancement as compared to the myometrium. K-trans came out to be 0.884 and the histopathology showed that it was a moderate differentiated squamous cell CA cervix. Patient 3 was a 31-year-old female with bleeding PV and passage of clots. Axial T2 and SASH T2 showed a mass lesion involving the cervical lesion. The diffusion weighted showed that the lesion was restricting. ADC minimum came out to be 559.7 and ADC mean came out to be 786.1. On dynamic contrast, the lesion showed an early enhancement again as compared to the myometrium. K-trans came out to be 1.851 and on histopathology, it was a poorly differentiated squamous cell CA cervix. Now, compiling the results, the demographic shows that the out of 13 patients, 7 patients were moderately differentiated squamous cell CA cervix, 3 were poorly differentiated, and 3 were well differentiated. Going on to the FIGO staging, 7 patients were stage 2B, 3 patients were of stage 3, 1 patient were of stage 4, 1 patient was stage 1B, and 1 was of stage 2A. Now, compiling the results, it has been seen that the mean ADC minimum and the K-trans value showed significant association with the grade. That is, poorly differentiated lesions had minimum or less ADC as compared to well-differentiated, which are higher ADC. Similarly, median K-trans were higher for poorly differentiated tumors and was lower for well-differentiated tumors. There was significant association as p-value was less than 0.05. Now, coming on to correlation of stage with ADC value and K-trans, there was no significant correlation of ADC values with the K-trans as the p-values did not come out to be less than 0.05. The scatter plots showing that there was no significant correlation between ADC values and staging or with K-trans and staging. Now, discussing previous studies with Liu et al. Showed that there was significant positive linear correlation between tumor cellular density and grade of tumor. Both minimum ADC value were correlated negatively with cellular density and pathological grade of tumor. Study conducted by Yamashita showed that on dynamic MR, area of the intense homogeneous enhancement showed increased permeability and increased K value. These very enhanced areas are predominantly composed of cancer cell vesicles, and radiation therapy were more effective in tumors with higher tissue permeability. Hassan did study showed that there was significant difference between mean ADC value of tumor grade and other tumor grades. Mean ADC value was less for squamous cell CA surface as compared to adeno CA, and mean ADC value were less in early stage as compared to in the ADC value of late stage. Present study in PM South Jung Hospital showed that there was significant association of minimum ADC value and K-trans value with the histopathological grade of squamous cell CA surface. No significant correlation of ADC and K-trans value was seen with the stage of tumor. Now, moving on to conclusions. Proves that tumor minimum ADC value and K-trans value shows association with tumor histopathological grade. Therefore, DWI and DC MRI can provide an objective method for predicting histopathological grade and can be used as a biomarker for prognosticating cancer surface. Now, these are my references that I have used for the